Welcome back. It is yours truly, Nick, a movie AV Impulse, and I just got out of the theater seeing Five Nights at Freddy's. Now, me not really being into the video game, I never really knew much about like the lore, the story behind it, so I kind of went in blind. But I do have a special guest with me today that is going to also go over the movie because they have played all the video games and they absolutely love it. So without any further ado, let me introduce my guest. Wait a minute. You know we got to get into that intro. And that special guest is my son, who played the game all the time. I remember buying him all the toys. Me and his mother used to go crazy trying to look for these Five Nights at Freddy's toys. So we went to the theater, the Dolby Theater. It was awesome as far as the surround sound goes. We had the subwoofer stuff, going underneath our, I asked him after the movie, like, how did he feel about it? And he had a couple of words. So, without spoiling it, what did you think of the movie? You being playing the video game and all that, how did you feel about where they went with the storyline?
It was okay.
Now, why was it okay?
Because they did add things to it.
What did you think of the animatronics?
They did a good job on them, but there were a lot of people complaining about the eyes.
Don't worry about other people complaining. That's why I told you, never watch a review until you do one.
There wasn't a review.
Oh, well.
Because the animatronics inside of Nightmare Mode, it's even on the posters, they don't have the blacked out eyes with the white pupils.
But during the movie, their eyes turned red. And then when they weren't being evil, their eyes went back to white, which I thought was pretty cool as far as that went. What did you think?
Yes.
For me, in terms of never playing the game, I looked at it. I went in, like, not really knowing the storyline or knowing anything like that. Do I think it's worth seeing in the theaters over watching it on Peacock? Yes. For being PG-13, it was very entertaining. What I would like to see is a rated R version of it, because we let our little guy, he's older than you think, we let him watch horror movies here and there after me and his mother analyze them. And, you know, if there's something inappropriate, he knows what to do, and then we move on. So he has been watching scary movies since the beginning of time, because horror should be introduced at a young age. Gets it out of their system. I just really enjoyed how they tied the characters in. The only thing that I will say, and I don't know if you're going to agree with this, Quentin, is that they rushed the Vanessa character very quickly, getting to know the main character, Mike. Basically what it is, without spoiling anything, is that Mike is basically having these dreams, and he could barely sleep, keeps getting up, keeps going back to sleep. He has to take sleeping pills to do it, and he's trying to...
You spoiled it.
I didn't spoil it.
No, okay, it's not in the trailer. It's not, it's any,
well, no he's, scene but, at but the he's show. Having dreams. I'm not spoiling it. Can't you tell me how to do my reviews? Okay. He ends up getting a job to go and watch the, Five Nights.
Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria.
There you go. Freddy's Faz, what is it?
Freddy Faz.
Freddy Faz Pizzeria? Okay.
Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria.
Okay, all right, bears. So he gets a job overnight security. I know you've all seen the trailers. When he's in there, what is going on is, like, there's things moving around. Now, I like how they introduced each of the characters, especially with the shadowing, the lighting. How did you feel? Do you think they should have just popped up out with them right away? Or do you think that the way they did it, slowly starting to show you all the characters, was a good idea? Or do you think they should have just popped out with them.
How do they do it in the video game? Do you see them before?
I mean, you see them on stage, but you don't, like, the current isn't covering them. You see them on stage, and they move, like, around sometimes whenever you're checking the cameras, but most of the time whenever you're off of them or switching them.
Plus, there is a post-credit scene, so you want to stay for that. It cuts right in. It's nothing crazy, but at the end, they do show you a post-credit. When the whole story at the end was revealed, were you shocked, or did you know what was going to go on?
I know.
Oh, you already knew what was going to go on?
Yeah, I guessed in the car.
You did guess in the car. Don't say it, because we don't want to spoil it, but you did guess in the car, and I told you, well, okay, we'll see. So, that was a pretty good guess. So, they stuck with the game on that part.
Yeah, but they did it. They did it not early. They just... No, if I say it, it would definitely be a spoiler.
All right, so then don't say it. Overall, you felt pretty good about the movie, though? You liked it? Would you recommend other kids your age in that 12 to 14, 15-year-old range going to see it? Because I would recommend all the grown-ups to go see it, because it's actually a really good movie for being PG-13, even if you don't know the storyline.
I recommend people that are 5 years old.
That's when you started, but not everybody thinks the same. We don't want to spoil it for you guys. We encourage you guys, if you do have Peacock, at least give it a watch. I would like to see a part two. Part three, they could really take this to a whole different level.
They're reportedly.
Reportedly. We're going to throw air quotations in there.
Only doing two more movies.
Yeah, but depending on how this goes, and this is something that I want to see go, because, like I said, even me, without knowing the storyline, it was super easy to get into. Like I said, the only thing I didn't like was how the Vanessa character just was, like, right in there and introduced.
I mean, she did kind of tie the story together.
Yes.
But they went, they didn't.
There should have been a little bit more development.
I can't remember it right now, but I don't think they went with it.
1 to 5. 5 stars being an awesome movie. 1 star being, I don't want to see it ever again. What would you give it? 3.5, 4.
The movies. For Scott Coffin, since he's beginning to make movies, probably a 3.5.
Well, he was just involved in the storyline. He didn't direct it.
He didn't direct it?
No.
That's probably why I went so off the wall.
Well, he helped with the storyline and the script, but he didn't direct it. But the director worked with the creator. But they have to change it. They always have to change it. Every game or everything like that, that's where things like this come into play. Ninja Turtles was changed.
All right, did you do a plug yet? Like and subscribe.
Oh, no. You want to do that for me?
Like and subscribe, or there will be a spider under your bed at 3 a.m. tonight.
I love this kid. This has been our spoiler-free weird review, but with my special guest, my little man. And let me know if you want to see more of him. We do watch a lot of movies together, so you know I could start adding him in, get him a little.
Did you loose. Ever do the Bumblebee movie?
No, but I mean Bumblebee has been done 100 times. What movie would you want to do together? Oh, we got that. We got that one that we seen in the theater coming out. The Wonka. You see his face? He don't want to see that. No? Are we all done? Can you just say, hit that like and subscribe again?
I did.
I know, but say it again.
Like.
And?
Subscribe.
This has been yours truly, Movie AV Impulse. Peace. Boss, I need a little bit more energy out of you.
Yes.
me.